Alright, so today we're going to learn how to turn fractions into decimals. So we're going to start with a fraction. Then I have 2/5, 7/8, and 37/100. Now, an easy way to think about this is to turn our fractions into a division problem. And our division problem will look like the numerator, or the top number, divided by the denominator, which looks like the bottom number, if that's what that is. Bottom number, right? Or if you look at it in the division box, where it is the numerator inside and the denominator on the outside. So, what that means is it will look like 2 divided by 5, or 2 divided by 5. Now, we just use our regular division rules. Okay, let's start with 5 divided by 2. Okay, well, 2 divided by 5. Can 5 go into 2? Well, no. 5 is greater than 2, so it can't. So we have a place in decimal here, place it on top as well, then we're going to annex a zero. That means add in or place in a zero. Okay? That turns this 2 into a 20. So now let's think 5 into 20. How many times can 5 go into 20? Well, that's easy if you know your multiplication facts. 5 can go into 20 4 times. So we put a 4, right, up there, and then we subtract 20. Now we're at 0, so we're done. So our decimal is 0.4, right? 2/5 looks like 0.4 as a decimal. Now let's tackle 7/8. Okay? So it is 7 divided by 8, so the numerator divided by the denominator, right? Put that in our division box. 7 goes on the inside, 8 goes on the outside. And again, we're met with the same thing we face in our first division problem. 8 can't go into a 7 because 7 is smaller. So we have to place in a decimal, right? And then annex a 0, or place in a 0. Well, 8 can go into 70. Alright, well, let's think of our multiplication facts. We know that 8 times 9 is 72, and that's just a little too much, so we can't do 9. So that automatically means that 8 times 8 is going to get us as close to 70 as we can without going over. So 8 times 8 is 64. And then we do subtraction. 70 minus 64. Well, 0 can't be minus by 4, so we're going to make that a 10. 10 minus 4 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. Okay, well, let's look at this. We're not at 0 yet, because we still have this 6. And 8 can't go into 6 because 6 is smaller, so we're going to have to annex another 0 and bring it down. Okay, now we're at 60. Okay, 8 can't go into 60 because we know that 8 times 8 is 64. 64 is too much, so that means that 7 is our next closest, right? So 7 times 8 is 56. So we'll do 60 minus 56, okay? 0 can't be minus by 6. So we cross this out, make it a 5. Make this 0 a 10. So 10 minus 6 is 4. 5 times 5 is 0, right? We're not at 0 yet, so we'll keep going. So we'll annex a third 0, bring it down, making this a 40. Alright, well, multiplication facts again. We know that 8 times 5 equals 40. So we'll put in 5, okay? And we will subtract 40. Alright, so there's the work. Our decimal is 0.875. Okay? And that was for 7/8. Okay? Then let's do 37 into 100 now. Sometimes the numbers are going to look big, sometimes you can simplify. But if you look at the examples that I've given you, these are in simplest form, alright? So, I'll start over here, do 37 over 100, right? 37 for 37 because 37 is smaller. So we're going to place in a decimal and annex a zero. Well, 37 is now 370. And because 370 is larger than 100, then we know 100 can go into it. Now let's think about how many times 100 can go into 370. We multiply 100 by 4, that gets us 400, but that's too much. So we'll have to multiply by 3, which will give us 300. So 3 times 100 is 300, and that's as close as we're going to get. So we'll put a 3 up top, right, above the 0 we just placed in there, and subtract 300. 0 minus 0 is 0, 7 minus 0 is 7, and 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, so I'm left with that 70, which we kind of knew was coming, right? So, 70 minus, 100 can't go into 70, so let's annex another 0 and bring it down, making this 700. All right, well that's a nice even number right there. We know that 100 can go into 700 seven times. So, 100 times 7 is 700. And there we go. We are at 0, and our decimal is 0.37. Okay? So there. That is how we turn our fractions into decimals.